the one you've been waiting for. The state's two most dangerous hitters facing off in the one and only California Battle League. X-Track versus Behn Grymm. And this ain't finna be no increase to peace rap. They gonna talk about shooting a motherfucker, killing a motherfucker, and fucking a motherfucker's bitch. This battle might just fight the murder rate more than Reagan and Benton crack cocaine. So if you ain't with that, turn this shit off and suck a dick.
They like, yo, X-Track. Why you always talk about the thugs and the techs? The slugs and the feds? The drugs and the checks? I give them a 360 shrug to the neck. Like, this is battle rap, motherfucker. What you expect? I don't care if you was a lean sipper or you sipping that mean liquor. My team squeeze triggers, blow his guts out, see if he got a clean liver. Boy, you look mad fake, like them high frame rate TV pictures. You think you Behn Grymm, I leave him stretched out, you Reed Richards. Fantastic Four when I let the palm cop. When I let the thing go, you could tell it he ain't a hard rock.
Adam, what did that one mean?
It's a superhero line. The other guy's name is Behn Grymm, which is the thing's alter ego from Fantastic Four. Reed Richards is the leader of the group, the stretchy guy.
Yeah, that part I got. What's the other meaning? You know, he's letting go of a thing. What's the thing?
It's a gun. It's a gun metaphor. Probably just assume everything is a gun metaphor.
And I kill anybody on this artist stage. Y'all know my slogan. Get this trash out of here. It's garbage day.
What you gonna do, Grymm? I just called you garbage. What you gonna do?
You said you got the thing on you.
Where's that?
Is it there? Is it here? I guess they must call your gun Sue Storm, because that bitch just disappeared. So he should do the right thing and walk away before I beat him to death. Because he gonna feel the hate in these punches. I'm ready to ride with the left. This motherfucker go online and Google fool porn. As is known to you, porn. You so fat, when you tuck a gun in your waist, you need to use a fucking shoehorn. I'ma take it past rap. Catch him not looking and drain the Mac fast. The way I blindsided this fat nigga, Sandra Bullock can save his black ass. Yeah, that's right. You used to be the shit. But lately, X fell in tears. It's the same as you outgrowing your shirt sizes. We ain't seen XXL in years.
Why does he keep saying X so much?
He's doing name flips. The guy's name is X-Trax, thus the X bars.
Bars?
It comes from the music term, like a bar of music, except in battle rap, it has a specific connotation, a bar instead of a line.
And the difference is?
It's hard to explain. More wordplay, most bars are based on homophones. X, XL, X, XL.
Oh, so if there's a homophobe, it's a bar.
Phone.
And your baby mom's only with you to collect those checks, bro. He be giving way more than just hugs and kisses to the ex-ho. X-O. All right. You wifed up a slut who gets piped down religiously like she's some sort of wasp. And you let her raise your seed. What, you thought you found a horticulture? Your baby boy is born, she got you. I know you wish you would have left that load in the hoe's mouth. How your name X-Track when you don't know when to pull out?
Oh, that is a bar.
Oh, okay, I get it. So the defining characteristic of a bar is just how much gross misogyny you can cram into one sentence.
Don't worry, it's all an act. I don't think X-Track even has kids. It's all for the sake of wordplay.
Puns about hating women. Aw. Look, I don't know how anybody can be a good person when they spend all of their time thinking of horrible things to say about someone.
See, I just dug your grave so they could put your fat ass corpse into it. It's so ironic, as much as you lift a fork, now they gotta forklift you.
My fans. spin? That was amazing. It was intense. Adam, we spoke on Twitter?
Twitter, right?
Academic, actually, grad student, working on my master's thesis.
What are you doing?
It's an English MA program.
I know what a thesis is. What are you doing at all?
Oh, the varied poetic functions of the N-word in battle rap.
That shit was tight, Wolf. You killed him. That XOXO ball? Fire.
Spank.
Respect. Respect.
Respect.
Respect.
I'm interested in how the N-word can be used as an intensifier for both comedic and intimidatory effect, or in some cases as a rhythmic flourish to hit a particular flow.
Yo, Grymm!
My girl wanna suck your dick, and I don't even mind. Respect.
I'm also interested in the racial identity aspect, for example, how Puerto Ricans and Dominicans use it to signify their African ancestry.
So you from New York?
I'm at Berkeley now, but yeah, how'd you know?
Well, you just mentioned Puerto Ricans and Dominicans. Are you from Cali? You would've said Mexican.
So Mexicans use the N-word too?
Well, it all depends, you know? Definitely in the Bay, right? Especially East Oakland. You know, they be giving all types of people passes over there. You remember a few years back, that white chick, D-Nasty?
Sure, she got some attention from Crayshawn when she had that one hit because they were in the same crew, right?
That was a battle rapper who wrote that one hit for her. I'm good, man. Things gonna be different in L.A., especially with that gang shit. No mess is going down there, Sam, without the hard earth.
This is great, man. Thank you.
Look, if you really want a nigga pass, the best bet, move back to New York. Claim you about a quarter Spanish. Maybe an eighth.
Or I could just move to East Oakland.
Better off claiming you Spanish.
Why would you? I'm not trying to get a pass.
Anytime a white boy asks who can say nigga, it's because he really want to say nigga.
It's just the subject of my thesis.
So you want to write nigga?
Oh shit, Behn fucking Grymm? Nigga, you gotta do a shot with me.
Respect.
Respect.
This is definitely a crash course.
What? You my favorite battle rapper.
Why are you talking to me? There's plenty of other N-words you can be asking me about N-words.
I guess it just made sense to start with my favorite writer. Your structure is crazy, man. The way that most battlers write, they do the wordplay, but the lines don't connect with each other. But with your stuff, the setup and the punchline all flows together conceptually, and then it all ties back into a larger theme or idea. It's like a master essay.
So you read essays all day about letting the chopper spray?
Yeah.
Respect. Next question.
Going down. Anywhere you meet me, guaranteed to go down.
There you are. I've been looking forever. What's a jump off?
Sorry. This is my girlfriend, Maya. Maya, this is Behn Grymm.
Hey, I am really glad that I get to talk to you about this. I mean, I was super surprised at the end by your battle there.
Maya, I don't think this is really a good time.
They didn't announce a winner or anything. I mean, what's up with that?
Oh, that. Judge battles aren't really a thing anymore.
You gotta blame your own coach for that. A bunch of delusionals just can't admit when they lost motherfuckers. New York hasn't lost a rap battle in 10 years. I clearly won, no.
Oakland, is y'all in here? If you got any drugs left, you need to let them shit circulate through your system right now, cause this next match finna be on some unprecedented seismic event type shit, you dig? Rap on my left, state your name, player.
And it's your boy, Big Z. Shout out to Oakland, the whole 510. Let's get it.
And the rapper to my right needs no introduction, but I'ma let him talk his shit anyway.
Megaton
Big! Is that guy stable?
The criminal jury may one day have to rule on that question.
I'm the only reason these people here know what your name is, but you're gonna be like Kim K after we take this, and I'm gonna be like Ray J since I'm the dickhead that's making you famous. As far as these fans, I told y'all from before, I'm the one that opened up this door. Yeah, I showed you my support. So now I'm like Chloe when she's going through divorce, cause I can leave the ring now since I don't hold him anymore. Man, black chicks love me. They think I'm an awesome person. And they always flirting. You could tell this chick here probably wants some Persian. Soon as I walked in and took off my turban, she got on the floor and she started twerking. Fuck your life, fuck your wife, fuck your whole entire existence. Man, if I seen Bill Cosby slip your wife a pill in her drink and I was the only eyewitness, I would mind my own business. Yeah. Me and you, man, we ain't the same. You nothing but a fake character. Man, we ain't from the same caliber. Give me space, man. Step back. This fist is a face damager. Give me distance and space so I'll leave your face with stitches like games manager. Yo, get out of my face.
all for this event.
What do you mean? There's two more after.
Get out of my fucking face!
That's what I mean.
It's so greasy, living in the D.E.T. Believe me, you won't catch a...
Damn, Mega really suck a dude, bruh.
Ain't no sucker. He warned you twice. What he supposed to do? Narrated on some March of the Penguin shit?
Well, we should probably take off. Thanks again for everything.
Make sure you send me that draft when you're done. Make sure you don't say nothing wild out of pocket.
Yeah, of course.
Bye. You definitely won that.
I said, yo! It's Billy Pistols, man. Let me talk to you for a quick second, all right? So I just saw you on the stage, but I want to know if you rep that real hip-hop shit. You know what I'm talking about? So what's good with you and me getting it in right now? If you really real, I'm ready to battle. Right now. Right now.
Look, man, I just finished the battle.
I don't need a stage. We could do this shit the street way. Shoot at his ride. It's like a helicopter accident. How I got this chopper on the freeway. Shells as big as coconuts. That's what I'm sending them. And your girl, I won't skip her. But after I'm done with you, I'ma chill again.
Did you just try to make kill again sound like Gilligan?
Man, niggas out here dropping Gilligan Island bars, bruh.
Man, that whole squad on that real shit. Only God could judge us. When we serving, it's like a hot plate. I warn you not
all
to
right,
touch us.
All right. I'm gonna let one of the little homies handle this. How about my young white boy here? He's a killer.
Actually, I don't rap.
So what's good then? You heard what I spit. Do you really think you could fuck with Billy Pistols, man? If that's the case, then spit your shit. Spit your shit!
Okay.
Oh.
You're here trying to battle Behn Grymm. Because he's got the kind of stardom you seek. But you'll never reach that bar. Because all your bars are a reach. You clearly wish you had a darker brown skin tone. You're suffering from I want to be Down syndrome. And also Down syndrome. You've been a dad since you were still a teen, but it's not how it really seems. That kid is not your son. He doesn't have a single Billie Jean. You spit all this gun talk of a violent mind at work, but got nothing to back it up with. That's a Miley Cyrus twerk.
Miley Cyrus just bodied Gilligan's Island.
Pistols.
Where you learn that shit?
I do some beat poetry sometimes.
Fuck a thesis. You got bars.
Speculation, cause today we gon' see what's the future of a pussy nigga hating on me. I give a fuck about the feds' investigation on me. I don't care that they at my shows and they waking on me. I'ma keep on flexing, popping, long the tube is on the beat.
Did that just happen? I can't believe that just happened.
It happened.
Can you tell me if my hand is still shaking? This was the greatest day of my life.
You didn't tell me that you rap.
I don't. Sometimes when I watch battles, lines will just pop in my head, but this time I just said it. It's really not that different than my poetry performances.
Words are weapons. Cause when the poets take up their arms together, it's what the mindless troops fear.
Yeah, I thought we agreed you weren't gonna do that.
Sure, we did. But I destroyed that guy, though, don't you think?
You beat him. I mean, I have a few notes that I would give you here and there.
It's so crazy seeing people react like that to poetry. We're just like you and me. We submit to journals hoping to get read by, what, 100 subscribers? What's a good turnout for one of those slam poetry nights? A couple dozen at best? But then you have these guys who are doing competitive poetry, which is what it really is, and they're selling out venues. They're getting tens of thousands, even millions of views on YouTube, and they're getting paid for it. This is what's happening in poetry right now, and instead we're giving awards to middle-aged Canadian men publishing postmodern Inuit fiction. Not that Kitzwala Tins isn't fantastic.
Oh, okay, so what? You want the Swedish Academy to start awarding a Nobel Prize for rap battles?
Oh, no. But what if I were to do it for real? Like that'll end.
Oh, you're serious? Babe, I mean, you don't exactly have a center stage personality. Do you really want to be another white guy shamelessly appropriating African-American culture? I mean, we don't need Macklemore. We need Mackleless.
Yeah.
I mean, you're not like that other white guy back there. And that works in your favor. I mean, you don't want to be like those guys. Trust me.
Yeah. Yeah. You're right.
When I ball, I'm positioned at the bar like a gymnast. I be sprinting for my money, run them drills like a dentist. My word in every breakfast when they're fresh, cause I meant it.
On page 423, Dostoevsky has Maximov quote what he calls a sarcastic epigram.
You're Sapphal, I'm Phaon. Agreed? But there's one thing still troubling me.
You don't know your way to the sea. Now, the poet Batyushkov is referring to the popular legend that Sappho, rejected by her lover Phaon,
killed herself by jumping from a seaside cliff. Ooh, that's actually just my second favorite poetic retort of all time. The first is, of course, from
LL Cool J,
who was told by a rival rapper that his tracks were too commercial and that, quote, 99% of his fans wore high heels. Whereupon LL responded with the immortal line, yeah, but 99% of his fans don't exist. So let's see your Drakes and your Nicki Minaj's drop a philosophical paradox that complex. Thanks, guys. Lady Seinfeld is a seminal text, but for Scheer, Sartre, and Dredd, I mean, you can't beat friends. Coffee shops and existentialism just go together, right?
I'll see you ladies later.
I was wondering if you had a minute to talk about my thesis subject.
It was a battle rap, right? Yeah. I thought you had some great material. You know, I'm just spitballing here, but maybe what you should do is compare modern-day rappers to ancient Japanese samurai and their poetic mastery of haiku and waka. Wait a minute. Sounds familiar. Is it possible somebody wrote that paper back in the 90s? Oh, yeah, that was me.
I know, but if you look at the scene going on now, I really think you'd see that it's really quite different.
Look at it. Don't you want to forge your own path here? I mean, who doesn't wish for their own father's death and all that? Look, be original. That's the whole point of the humanities. You can make up whatever bullshit you want, as long as you're smart enough to justify it. Write about the rise of comic book movies as the ultimate crisis in the American male psyche. Actually, don't. That's good. I'm keeping it.
Sorry to have wasted your time.
Hey, Adam. You coming to the house party tonight? As long as you wear a shirt besides that one?
Yeah, sure.
Hey, and call your mother. She worries about you out here.
Sure thing, Dad.
So he shut you down entirely?
Well, I don't know if I would say shut down.
Really? Because it sounds like he heard your idea and took a giant shit all over it, and then used that shit to fertilize a garden growing organic, certified GMO-free vegetables, which he then ate and shit all over your idea again.
Okay, say shut down.
I know it's intimidating being the son of probably the most famous literary critic in the country, but you need to stand up for yourself.
Yeah, you're right.
Although you should change your thesis topic.
Yeah, you're right.
I mean, I respect your enthusiasm for researching across cultural boundaries, but think about the kind of culture you're validating. What if, instead, you were to discover and advocate for the next Angelou or Baldwin or even, oh, the next Shakur?
Ooh, like Tupac?
Asada. Ugh. Can't campus security do anything about that?
Not unless he's causing a disturbance.
The best part of full communism is gonna be when everyone has equal access to hygiene products.
It's the perfect timing. You see the man shining.
So Mailer told me that being a father was the most rewarding thing in his life. And I told him, you must have never tried cocaine.
When you
look at a diamond, you might as well just see a sad little baby arm because that's what it cost.
Adam, you must love having your dad work at the university. Getting to come to these swanky dinner parties, rubbing shoulders with the Berkeley elite. It's amazing.
Love is a strong word, as is dad.
Bit of a different vibe than that rap battle you guys went to, I bet.
Oh my God, Becky. You should have heard the violence and misogyny that these people were cheering for. You would have been horrified.
What's this I heard about you battling someone, Adam? Do tell.
This weird guy came up to us in the parking lot after, and out of nowhere, he just starts rapping at us. And Adam rapped back at him.
And I won. Just to not leave you hanging on the outcome.
That is so cool. I don't even know that you rap.
He doesn't.
I don't. I just like coming up with lines for people for fun.
Ooh, do me. Like, what would you say to me if we were battling right now?
I don't think so.
Oh, do me. You can say anything you want.
Do me.
Yeah, do Becky.
Sorry, there's just nothing to insult about you guys.
Okay.
You know, something that I'll never understand about this rap stuff is, the shoot this, shoot that, shoot the dog, shoot the grandma. I mean, talk about contributing your own stereotypes.
You're such a pretentious prick. You have peppermint excrement. You stay trolling all boy high schools. That's why you dress up in this preppy shit.
John, that is so racist. I mean, you can hardly blame a marginalized group for their own internalized white supremacy when society has been actively enforcing it since its inception.
Well, actually, that's racist. You're positing a total lack of self-determination on the minority's part. I've always seen African-American rappers' hyperbole as self-aware. Like, we know this is what white people think of us, so we're more than happy to sell it back to you.
Those are such fucking hipster glasses. When you wear them, real life has an Instagram filter added.
Okay, so now you're just treating an entire racialized group as a monolith? I mean, that is way more racist.
I can't be racist. I'm Asian.
Asian people can definitely be racist.
Racism is the systemic oppression of people of color. I'm a person of color, ergo, not racist.
This guy is so hairless, white, and sterile. You look like a female model from American Apparel.
Oh, please. Asians are not people of color. You're more like off-white.
Okay, can we at least all agree that that was racist?
Yes. I'm sorry, that. You know what? My inner proud black woman says, fuck all you bitches.
So wait, Robert can literally claim to be a black woman, but you don't think that that's racist?
He's expressing the well-known historic affinity between gay and black culture, Adam.
Don't be such a fucking homophobe.
We out here trying to book this next event, you feel me? And you know I needed to holler at the parking lot predator, aka Blacktop Assassin, aka the nerd who needs no revenge to see what's popping with you.
I think you have the wrong number.
Nah, G, this is Donnie Narco, head of the California Battle League's new talent recruitment and all types of other legal shit.
Is this a prank? Your exaggerated bonics is offensive.
See, you a funny dude. The homie Behn Grymm said you committed some first-degree murder outside the last event. Some get investigated by podcast-type shit.
Wait, you're actually from KBL? Shut the front door.
Adam, shut the front door, please.
Hey, so check it. We got a tryout card coming up in 2 weeks. You got a spot if you want it, man. Hey, Adam.
The hey, man, banana the kale ice cream and chicken and nuggets.
Sorry, what did you say?
I said I'm late to meet Becky and I could use your help.
You're asked to show a little acknowledgement.
A little acknowledgement would be nice. Are you even listening to me?
Listen to me. You animal, homie.
I love animals.
Yeah. Exactly. I mean, no sentient being need live in its own filth on the way to being barbarically slaughtered just so that we can dose ourselves in growth hormones. And the least you could do in order to fulfill our commitment to animal justice is put the groceries in the goddamn fridge.
I'll do it.
All right, partner. Good luck.
Oh, thank you.
Hey, we finna make this the classic for real, for real.
Ooh, what are you eating?
This is some bullshit. Hello? Aw, oh, man, I knew I shouldn't have called you on the trap phone.
Mm. It is amazing what they can do with tofu these days.
Yo, Adam.
Love you.
Love you.
Hey, look, it's all love, G. So peep this. I'm gonna put you up against another young gun on the come up. Real dope spitter by the name of Prospect.
Prospect.
Hey, what's your name, pimpin'?
Adam Merkin.
I don't actually have a rap name. That's my real name.
It's your real name because you really about that life. Hey, all right, homie, I'm gonna get with you in a minute. I gotta go fuck my bitch.
Peace.
Ting drinking is very bad. Yo, I got a fake ID though.
Asian.
Race angle, bad driver, eats cats, dogs, small penis. That, don't you? Too racist? Smokes a lot of weed. Smokes a lot of weed. Also probably sells it. Loves his grandma.
Another great Sylvia Plath.
You're sweet. If you're moving grams, it means your grandma got a new apartment. You're not a rapper, you're just a cop with a nice flow. I can tell you're a narc, even your height is 5'0". I might have to kill this kid. That's pro-choice. Too offensive. The most effective birth control you'll ever use is the prospect of sex with you.
Blunt. I'm like your biggest fan. The 2-on-2 you guys do, it changed the game.
Thanks, bro. Bring your equipment to the center. That's where we're gonna need it.
My equipment?
Bro, the cameras and shit.
Oh, I'm not a cameraman. I'm a rapper.
Oh, rapper.
I have a tryout tonight. At least I'm supposed to. I'm super late. Google Maps got me all screwed up. Did I miss the whole thing already?
Bro, the battles ain't start yet. We on color people time.
White though. Can't say that. Hey, what you white boys call it? Hip-hop time, right? We on hip-hop time right now.
I like your jacket, though. Where the rest of the members at?
Members?
Man, you weren't even alive when the members-only jackets came out. Oh, last minute.
That nigga's so white. He make Michael Jackson look like Michael Jackson.
Hey, listen to him, man. You hater. Hey, I loved Home Alone. Where you was in them traps? Yeah, we be out there.
Oh, looking at why he look like One Direction? If they went both ways, though.
Bro, you listen to One Direction?
Bro, you really gonna go on his... You earthworm gym-looking ass nigga. I know you ain't switching sides. Look at your shit.
I know you ain't talking. It's your leg over here lying, man.
Oh, come on, man.
Detach that shit, man.
Bro, you know I'm insecure about that, bro.
This your first battle, huh? What's your name, homie?
I don't really have one. I guess it's Adam.
Che Coleon. Don't trip on those two, man. They just love roasting fools. Rappers each other, whoever's around to get it. But I'm sensing you're more the type of dude who, like myself, stays focused on what's really important.
Battles.
Bitches.
Oh, there are ladies here?
What do you mean, man? It's a great turnout tonight. Mm. See? Those two over there? That's what I'm about. Trying to come spill while getting me or what?
You want me to be a wingman?
Mm-hmm.
Let me guess, you want me to talk to the big girl so you're free to talk to her friend?
Now fuck no, man. The big girl was mine. Fuck out of here. Yeah, she big, but she fine as hell. Takes a real man to smash a fine fat bitch. Come on, let's go. Hey, mommy. We just wanted to personally thank you for your support. As two up-and-coming battle rappers ourselves, we appreciate the love.
I'll see you a battle rapper. Damn. Tanya, he said he's a battle rapper. You look a little familiar, come to think of it.
Sure I do. Che Coleon.
Right. You're the one who battled Chambers last event.
Oh, so you know about me. I could tell you're a woman of discerning taste.
Discerning enough to know that Chambers bodied you 3-0. And the battle before that, you got washed. And the battle before that, your soul damn near left the earth. So how about you spend less time on your pickup lines for me and more time on your lines for your next opponent before you take your 4th L in a row?
You're lucky you got an ass, because your battle opinions are garbage.
Have you considered jumping into a battle? I have a feeling you would do very well.
Oh, did I forget to mention I'm the second match on the card tonight? Divine Wright. Nice to meet you.
And she got bars, too? If you can cook, I might just be in love.
I can cook you in the ring, motherfucker!
Ah, damn, man. Sorry, homies. My bad. You know we running on that hip-hop time. What up? What up? What up? All right, let's shoot this bitch real quick. No Selena. What up, Oakland? Yeah! Town business, baby! right, what's up? This is the California Battle League, and I'll be your host, Donnie Narco, a.k.a. the Walking Drug Lab, a.k.a. the Cocaine Cowboy, a.k.a. Mr. Splash. Put my drink on your bitch's ass and won't even tip the glass. You feel me? All right, cool, cool. First up, we got a cool one-round battle to kick off these tryouts. To my right, straight out of Koreatown, Los Angeles, give it up for Prospect.
L.A., baby. Shout out to Oakland, no shout out. Make some noise, let's go.
And to my left, we got a newcomer on the scene who I hear gonna be a real problem, Adam Merkin.
It's just Adam.
Just Adam? Oh, okay, cool. He on that Cher, Ronaldo, Roseanne type vibe. I feel you, player. All right, well, since you the new white boy on the scene, we're gonna show you a little bit of love. It's on you, Prospect. Get him.
Yo, who the fuck set me up with this little homo? This kid look like he should be doing Disney promos. He look like he loved writing essays like a prison cholo. His yearbook photo looked like the bitch from the Wendy's logo. You probably came here in a Budweiser truck with a bumper sticker that says, I'll die for Trump. Basically, what I'm saying is you white as fuck. Looking like Conan O'Brien's son or the little dude on the logo for Hawaiian Punch.
Ha ha, white people.
How the fuck is this white nerd gonna outsmart this Asian? What the fuck are you doing? You seen Virginia Tech, we're even better at school shootings.
He's a ninja.
Finish him.
Don't buy drugs from this man, just a word of advice. He's either a cop or reporter, either way, he's working for Vice. Actually, if I'm really squinting, you kind of look like Tilda Swinton. Actually, he kind of look like one of them YouTube kids on Ellen DeGeneres when she feeling hella generous. Probably getting the fights like, let me at him. Actually, his butler be fighting for him like, let me at him.
Privilege,
man. These yuppies are the worst. Can you picture him in a Starbucks line with Ugg boots and a puppy in his purse petting it like, OMG, you're so fluffy that it hurts.
Puppy in his purse, eating dogs, got some takeout. No, it's too racist. Can't be racist. Disney logo. D looks like a G. Virginia Tech. It's offensive. Virginia Tech disturbing the dead.
Motherfucking oh, the irony. You look like Ron Weasley, but you sound like Hermione. I'm Asian, so it's only right that I'm serving this ginger. I saw this nerd up on Tinder. He had Little Mermaid as his picture. So I don't know if I should slap you like a bitch or punch your face like a man. Cause I keep switching from open palm to a fist, like a white boy shaking your hand.
It's gonna be hard to recover from that one, but let's see what he got. It's on Adam, let's get it.
I can't believe this guy's up here talking about Virginia Tech. That's offensive to the victims and their families. Why are you disturbing the dead? You need to stop. If I did Disney promo, that means that I popped. You kind of remind me of the D in Disney. You look like a G, but you're not. When they talk about top prospects, they don't even call your name out. I do have a puppy in my bag. I'm delivering your takeout. Yo, you're so Asian, you can use a piece of string as an eye mask. And when you watch movies on your iPad, it looks like an IMAX. Beating me? That's harder than you trying to score with divas, pronouncing broccoli properly, or getting a border visa to North Korea. Even Asian bitches won't fuck you. That means you're hella frail. Ordering tuna at sushi's the only time you get yellow tail. Cause your dick is so small, you can't tell your cock from your testicles. Something's wrong with your genitals when your bitch would rather fuck octopus tentacles. So yeah, you're hustling weed, but you're the corner boy stuck in the streets. It's bonsai.
You just take a real cuff from the tweeze.
You talk about killing people in your rhymes and act like you have real homies? It's like your anime girl pillows. Stop pretending they're real bodies. Cause actual G's, you ain't kill none. So shut the fuck up and chill some. Just cause you look like Kim Jong-un doesn't mean you're ill, son. And since you believe in feng shui, I'm gonna break in as an intruder at night, move your couch an inch or two to the right, and fucking ruin your life. Yo, your whole crew looks like an Asian porn star where they censor around where her bush be. Cause all I see is a bunch of squares surrounding this pussy. This murder's so cold you can see this man's breath. I'll kill your supporters too for sleeping. That's Korean fan death. Will you be a little boy or a geriatric for your lifespan? Oh, you got some egg in your face, which makes sense because it's shaped like a fucking frying pan. See, I had a trap set. You just planted in my plan because you really don't know what you're fucking with, like you had a one-night stand in Thailand. Faggot!
But coming up, we got an all-female tryout battle. Lady Deathstrike versus Divine Right coming up, you dig?
Woo!
You deserve a round after that shit. You nice. Your hairstyle look like a gay-ass Tim Burton character, but you nice.
Thanks, man. You are amazing, though. I know everyone online is gonna say that you out-rapped me, but I'm so glad my bars went over so well. I was worried about that for a minute.
Woo! You had some creative Asian shit. Motherfuckers come at me with hella corny jokes. But you did them well, bro.
You think?
Shit, at least you knew I was Korean instead of calling me chink the whole time. As far as I'm concerned, that's culturally sensitive by battle rap standards. Race angle's some shit I gotta deal with, you know?
Hey, I'm just glad you know that I'm not racist for real. I was worried about that.
인종차별 양키 새끼.
Thanks, man.
Yo, I got a female admirer that wants to make your acquaintance. This is Adam. He's been a homie from way back. I pretty much introduced him to the game, you could say.
I really loved your performance.
What was one of your favorite lines?
I liked when you was making fun of him for being Asian. You know, I never really been into skinny white boys before, but maybe you could open my horizon.
Adam, why don't you give her a phone?
The phone?
Yeah, you give her your phone, then she puts her number in it, then she has your number. That's how this shit works.
Yeah. I actually have to make a quick phone call. Excuse me. I'm sorry.
You just leave like that. I brought you the girl. Okay. Yeah, Lady Deathstrike won that coin toss, so it's 2 minutes on Divine Right. Kick that shit, baby.
I'm a bitch who loves shopping. I just copped a Magnum Eclipse. No boob job, but I got some new cans for this bitch. You got your name from a comic? Lady Deathstrike, but you the last type. Those long nails will fuck up your sex life.
Yo, saw your battle. That shit was tight. Keep at it.
Sex.
Shit was crazy. I never set bars like that from a goofy ass white boy like you. Do what you're worth.
Specs.
Adam.
Hey, babe.
Where are you? I've been calling you for hours.
I know, I'm at the library and my phone was on silent, so I forgot to check it. I'm really, really...
You a straight killer, cuz!
Respect. What?
Adam. You out there killing it, huh? The streets is talking.
That audience reaction, it's like heroin. Not that I would generalize about African-Americans and drugs.
Hey, keep it down. I'm sleeping.
Right, sorry.
Look, they doing this event in L.A. next month. They got this new crazy promoter dishing out crazy dope. And, you know, I'm just seeing if you want to catch up on some bills.
L.A. For the whole weekend?
Yeah, they pay for your hotel and everything. Representing for me, my little protege, so can't make me look bad out there.
No pressure, then.
Shh.
Sorry, I have to talk to him here because my girlfriend can't know. Not that it's a gay thing. Yeah, sure, I'm in. Not that it's specifically not a gay thing.
Well, some of us are trying to study.
Look, man, what's up with the thesis and the questions that you gotta ask me? What's up with that?
Right, a thesis. So one thing I've noticed that changes in the tone of the N-word is whether it's preceded by a possessive pronoun or an adjective. For example, my N-word or her
N-word versus...
Come on, bro. You really gonna hit me with that N-word shit like that? See, now that makes it 10 times more offensive because you insulted my intelligence, too. Just say my nigga.
Are you sure?
I know I checked you before. It's a difference between using the word and referencing the word. You gotta use the word like how Obama said it. Get me using like how all them other presidents said it.
All right. What I've noticed is the difference between using a possessive pronoun like...
My nigga.
There you go. Or
her nigga.
Versus an adjective like this nigga or a funny...
nigga. Okay, wait. Time out. Are you trying to learn how to use these phrases in a rap battle?
Yes. No. Yes?
This nigga.
You say I'm cold to the touch, could've told you this much. As I go for the gusto, bending you over the hutch, but you're ready to spread, can't tell if you're squirting.
Wow, they have cashew cheddar nut loaf quesadillas. No cheese or bread.
Adam, this place is perfect. What's the occasion?
Actually, there's something I was hoping to talk to you about.
Namaste. I'm feeling really good energy from this table. Mm. Are you ready to order? Maybe a juice to energize, relax, detox?
If I could just have a minute.
I would love a carrot ginger juice, but could you substitute kale for the spinach, beet for the celery, mango for the apple, lime for the lemon, parsley for the ginger, and cucumber for the carrot, if it's not too much trouble.
Fuck yeah.
So, what I need to talk to you about, it's something that
you
I
You fucked someone.
Oh, no, it's nothing
you
like that.
You fucked someone, didn't you? I knew it.
I just did a rap battle.
What?
It's really not a big deal, really. It's just something I wanted to do, and I did well enough that I actually have another one booked in LA next month. So I was thinking we should go together. Like a fun weekend trip.
Like a fun weekend trip.
Doesn't that sound fun?
I'll tell you what it sounds like. It sounds like you going behind my back and doing the one thing we explicitly agreed you weren't gonna do. Not to mention the misogynistic, homophobic, ableist...
Saying rap music glorifies violence. Don't you think that's a little racist? Reductivist, colonialist. Don't you think that sounds a little bit colonialist?
Excuse me?
I mean, you're passing judgment on a grassroots African-American culture based on your own privileged white perspective. That just seems like a colonialist critique rather than honestly engaging with them on their own terms. You know, that is why I didn't tell you about the battle in the first place. I knew you being there would be problematic.
Are you saying that if I don't go to LA with you and support you in battling, it makes me racist?
Yep.
I never thought about it that way.
That is because there are systems in place that keep you thinking that way.
Wow. You're right. I have been so caught up in my own privilege that I never thought to examine battling from an authentic and textual point of view.
We all slip up sometimes.
Okay, so help me understand. Like, what's an example of a line you would say? What's something you would say to me?
I don't think that's a good idea.
I'm trying to understand here. I am trying to engage. Adam, if you love me, you'll insult me in a rhyme. Right now.
Okay. Okay.
How about this? I'm just here to respect women and treat them equally. I took you to a vegan eatery. Why would you have some beef with me?
Oh my God, that's so good. Go again.
Your crunchy granola. I can tell by your pungent aroma. You smell like swamp water. I'm worried you've been fucking with Yoda. And your whole fucking style is more tasteless than this tofu. The way I kill you with rhymes, I'm like your deadbeat mother. I disown you!
What the fuck, Adam? Get the fuck out.
Oh, you don't understand. She actually asked me to say that. Well, not that exactly, but we were just joking around. I was actually coming up with hypothetical rap battle lines to say to her. You know, like if I looked at your shirt and said something like, it's funny you have a shirt with Bob Marley because your pussy hair looks like a cross between him and Rob Zombie. Okay, bad example.
Chris!
Trying to be his boyfriend. Sorry about this place. It's not exactly what I expected, and I'm sorry about everything.
Okay, Adam, you've been apologizing for days. You apologized the whole 6-hour drive here. Could you just not anymore? I still agreed to come, didn't I? Now let's just try to have a culturally enriching experience.
Oh,
shit, is this albino mole rat looking motherfucker? They got everybody in this telly. Dude, I gotta see you later, mommy. You're right, I gotta talk to my boy.
You good? Ride down with Smooth?
Yeah.
Let go, let go. How you doing?
I watched your prospect battle back like 10 times. When you say your chick would rather fuck octopus tentacles, yo, that was cool.
Thanks, man. Hey, who's the girl?
She's just some tender bitch. I had to get the good luck done before the battle goes on, you know what I'm saying? I mean, it would've been better luck if it was from Bay, but she playing.
What? Divine. Have you met my girlfriend, Maya? Maya, this is Divine Wright, a very talented female battler.
Maya was good.
Wow, awesome. You know, it's really amazing to meet you. I really respect what you're doing, breaking ground as a woman in such a male-dominated pursuit. Okay,
what does me being a woman got to do with it? I'm spitting rhymes out of my vagina.
Woo! We about to head out to the venue. You want to stash your bags and follow?
Let's do it. Guess upstairs?
That ain't up.
Yo, all my life I dream of fame and success. Finally, we made it.
Classic battle shit. Kid get a bunch of money, decides he wants to be a promoter now. Spends everything he got on getting some names and put us up against a bunch of bums. Now they vet no one comes to.
Man, who cares? I'm from North Richmond. As long as I'm getting paid, I'll battle in a fucking sewage drain. Y'all a bunch of divas.
I know. Men, right?
Is that Megaton? What is he doing here?
This city.
But why is he rapping here?
They must have paid him a couple stacks more than the rest of us. What I'm wondering is, who is that nigga?
That looks like... I think that's the dude I'm battling.
Shit. You rocking the groom tux. I'm about to get up there and marry your ass.
That's my dad's wedding photo.
He looked like he dug up Prince and stole the nigga's suit.
You sure he stole the nigga's suit?
What's good, y'all? It's your host, Freddie Hustle. We about to get it cracking for the inaugural event of Freddie Hustle Entertainment. Let's get this battle started. Battler to my right.
I said, yo. Your mom's pussy got one star on her Yelp review. I didn't even come to battle. I just have a question that I want to ask of my girl. Will you do me the honor of making me the happiest man in the world?
I make him double up in the middle like a tummy tuck. The shot of your blow his guts out. That's a stomach pump. Stomach pump. Stomach pump. Wait, I got it. Stomach pump.
I probably lift him off his feet if I aim my clock. And that's the first time a black guy'll get raised by pops.
I just want you to be my bouquet. I even got you this bouquet. You like guns? We can go shopping together. I'll buy my bouquets.
And your girl uses Dijon mustard when she eats her boogies. I'll show up to your grandmother's open casket and give that bitch a noogie.
His sister got mad kids. Just had another couple. And every time he's like, damn, well, I'll be a monkey's uncle.
And a shot of your blow his guts out. That's a stomach pump. And your girl's memory foam mattress remembers that she's a fucking slut. What was my next line?
Fuck.
All right, rapper to my left, let's go, get him.
You a comedian, like John Belushi, Chris Farley, Robin Williams. If you haven't figured it out by now, save us all some time and kill yourself right now.
You ain't getting married, you're getting buried. But you still dress suitable, nigga. I let each gun ring twice, bang, 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 bang. Four weddings and a funeral, nigga.
This dude forgot all the rhymes he studied. Call him Sway. He don't know the answers. He's like a kid's warning label. This toy's a choking hazard.
So you want to talk that racist shit? I know your girl. And I'm pimping the thot. It's a reverse slavery auction. I put your bitch on the block.
Shoot him. Then check for the body shakes. That's how you can tell the death's gripped him. It's like a good ass orgasm. Why must I have your legs switching?
You're so fat that you run out of breath downloading the app to count your steps. If you were on house arrest, you'd have to take walking breaks to give your house a rest.
If he was really provoking, he would have seen all types of colors. Because with a kid, I'd have sculpted him. Get it? All types of colors? Kaleidoscope him? Yeah, see, I'll get it.
Time!
Yo, check it.
Shut the fuck up, little squirmy little Reddit blogger. Another Eminem imposter refers to Elton John as his second father. Bob Saget, Rick Moranis, Kelly Osbourne, white trash, genetic monster. Probably conceived in the back of a Led Zeppelin concert.
If Harry Potter had sex with Jeffrey Dahmer, you'd be their lesbian daughter.
The fuck are you, a little fucking state prison fucking rape victim? He's a new face of racism. I'm surprised you didn't show up here today with a slave with him chained to him. He hates African-American culture because he was raised different. He hates Clinton, Abe Lincoln, pretty much anybody that can relate with him except Blake Griffin. He feels a little bit more safe with him because they share the same pigment. Bitch, hip-hop has been for minorities. It's never been for you geeky asses. Matter of fact, what are these, your little fucking reading glasses you need for your English classes? Man, give me that shit. Man, I'll stomp these into pieces and fragments, and now you can keep them. He can have this. Now you get to complete your dream of being this genius math whiz because everything you see is in fractions. Now get the fuck out of here, you little fucking dweeby faggot.
Man, y'all see that shit? He made that kid cry like tears. That's not right.
Man, fuck a battle career. He ended dude life. You're gonna need a new face transplant, new social security number.
Make it soon. First battle rapper quoted in Suicide Note.
That whole verse was crazy.
Ow, Adam, I'm right here.
Oh, hey, babe, wasn't that unbelievable? Hey, can you get me a drink from the bar?
Yo, Mega one of the all-time greats of this shit.
Ah, come on, Eminem is the greatest battle rapper of all time.
I'm sorry, fellas, I forgot. It's a white boy in our presence, so you know we're contractually obligated to mention Eminem.
Hold up. How your man supposed to be the greatest and he get bodied in his own fictional movie? Right. Lotto washed him in 8 Mile. Then lickety split get him two, bro.
Then he go body himself for a whole round, you know what I'm saying? Papa Doc ain't choke. He just knew it was over, so he walked off, man. Em took his own L.
Plus, how you supposed to be the greatest and your video director some Filipino nigga making gay-ass art films for your jokes, right?
It's not 1992. M's skill transcends race.
You talking about M? He's the fucking GOAT, man.
You're right. He's better at putting words together than all these black guys.
Go away.
Yo, you said some wild shit up there, homie.
Fuck out of here, man. This is battle rap. I could diss Asians, Mexicans, any other race. Why not blacks? I'm just trying to fight for equality.
Hey, got a point, bro.
What?
Plus, I thought that shit was hilarious, man. I love this nigga.
Keep it on.
Man, hey, look, the way you keep it real, how you feel, and I feel that.
Yo, any of y'all seen a hotel key card laying around anywhere? Can't remember where I put it.
What hotel's it for?
Can't remember.
Fuck y'all, man.
What? Get your ass out of here.
Damn, this is messy as fuck, bro. Yo, let's peel out. I got a dope food spot I want to take y'all to.
Adam? I want to go back to the hotel now.
Okay, I think some of the guys are gonna grab some food, but I can drop you off on the way.
Okay, I want you to think really hard about what the best thing to do is, and then I want you to do it.
Ask your fam, I am the motherfucking man!
So you dropped your girl off?
She dropped me.
She not taking you back?
More or less, those words.
You did the right thing, bro.
Yeah, that's fine. I'm sure we'll be fine. Hey, can I drop this in someone's car? Maya was my ride home.
Like, I got you, dawg. Just know you're gonna be designated driver, though.
Yo, the homie just texted me that Megaton's having an after party at the crib later. Shit's gonna be lit! Come
on. Okay.
Woo! White folks driving us around tonight!
I graduated at the street, I'm a real OG. So while you niggas acting bad, you gon' have to show me.
Let me get this shit straight. We in LA and the Mexican takes us to a sushi joint.
I'm with D. Wrong for this one.
First off, I'm Ecuadorian, motherfuckers. Second, the chef here came highly recommended.
No way. Take that back. You dead wrong for this one.
My LA Connect saw him working here and told me about it. I had to come see for myself.
Okay, what can I get y'all started with?
I got a quick question. I heard you're so Asian, when you watch movies on your iPad, it looks like an IMAX. Can you confirm?
Oh, hell nah.
You should be proud. You dress like you about to take a yellow belt test. It's your lucky day.
No, he looked good in his uniform. It really brings out his eyes.
Man, fuck all of y'all.
What are you doing making sushi anyway? You're Korean.
There ain't enough Japanese to keep up with how much white people love this shit. Half of the sushi joints here are owned by Koreans. We just pretend to be Japanese. Y'all too ignorant to know the difference.
You walking Asian stereotype, bro. You probably fought like 50 ninjas on the way here, huh?
Drove a Civic and drifted the whole way.
It must be hella hard to write the customer's checks in that crazy ass calligraphy.
Yeah, that's true.
What do you do after work? Go home, pretend to rape your grandma?
Yo.
What the fuck, bro?
You know, because you're Korean, but you're pretending to be Japanese. And Japan occupied Korea for a long time, and they committed a lot of atrocities. I thought we were roasting them.
We was talking some ignorant Asian shit. Then you went and brought his real history into it.
Not cool, bro.
It'd be best for you all to leave.
Sensei, these are my friends. We're just joking around.
Sensei? Yo, Mr. Miyagi is real. Yo, Hollywood owes you all kinds of royalties, bro.
Come call me. That to my face.
Yo, this old ass. Hong Kong fooling motherfucker really trying to start some shit with me.
Oh, oh shit!
He kicked my face!
We should get him out of here.
He kicked me in the motherfucking face, man. Let me hit him.
You want
him?
No. Get your ass out. Come on.
An old martial arts master doing a spin kick in the middle of a sushi restaurant? Really? Do you even know how much of a fucking stereotype you made us look like? You sent Asians back 100 years.
Shay was right. Vega lives in the hood for real.
Are you sure this is the hood? These houses are all really big. And they have lawns.
You really from New York, huh?
Fuck, is this a Captain Planet reunion? What's up, Jay? Prospect, baby girl, Behn Grymm was good, homie.
I don't think you met my guy, Adam.
Nah, we ain't met. Seen your shit, though. You all right, homie?
Thanks, man. I'm a huge fan of you.
All right, we got bitches, blunts going around, hookers, pregnant prostitutes, white girl, Molly. It's that West Coast hospitality, baby. God,
please keep these fuck niggas from around me.
Shit is crazy. That Virginia Tech line got bars, for real.
Respect. It's just that whole Asian shit began to me. No matter what I say, they can say some cliche-ass kung fu lines and it pops off.
Okay, it's always the same shit for me, too. Whenever I battle a nigga, I know everything he gonna say to me. I mean, that groom shit was a little different, but at the end of the day, it's the same shit, just based on my gender.
So how you break out of that?
You don't. No matter what, I'm gonna get the bitch bars, and you gonna get the Asian bars, and this kid, I always get the white-ass nerd box.
Not really a nerd, though. Yeah, never mind.
Battling is an expectations game. Niggas gonna always come with the expected shit because that's what the audience wants to hear. But the fact that you can expect it means you can flip it. Play it to your advantage.
Yo, it is on. I don't even know this bitch's name, but she's a fucking smoke show, and she's all over me. I'm about to smash for real.
Don't you think it's a problem that you don't know her name?
Yo, the only problem's gonna be when I'm fucking so hard, her teenage daughter's gonna get pregnant in the future.
Shit, how can that motherfucker get laid off battling? For me, it just makes it harder. I tell a nigga I battle and his dick start tucking up like it's the silence of the lambs. I need a drink.
Yo, I swear that's... Nah, it can't be.
Nor from somewhere?
Yeah, from jerking off. That's Bella Backwoods, yo. I've been following her since teen vids all the way to MILF. That's 3 years.
That actually is a long time to follow a porn star.
I'm saying, though. Fuck! We gotta stop Che.
Because of his deeply problematic attitude towards hookups and women in general?
No, because of this.
We should get Ben.
Oh, damn, man, y'all perverse, man. Oh, you trying to get a picture for the gram, huh?
Take that shit.
Oh, put your damn pants on.
All right, shit, man. You trying to hit this shit too? Well, at least let me finish first.
Man, that's Megatons, girl, you dumbass nigga. You better hope and pray to see you come in here or you all will be getting fucked. Hurry up!
Okay.
Back up. If anything, this is between Bella and her boyfriend. Are we seriously suggesting that Shay is somehow vaginally trespassing on another man's property? So Bella has no sexual agency or bodily autonomy here?
Ain't none of us gonna have bodily autonomy if we did.
Deal with this fucking whore later. Right now, I'm gonna have some words with my gardener real quick.
Look, he didn't mean to disrespect you. He's just a knucklehead. If he would've knew anything...
Get the fuck out of my way, dog. This don't even concern you.
Well, I'm making it my concern.
Why? Because you're the big homie now? Would you fucking vouch for him all of a sudden?
He didn't mean anything.
We battle rappers. We battle each other and disrespect each other in the ring as rappers. But to come to my house and fuck my girl, you disrespected me as a man. So now we're gonna have to handle that as men.
If you wanna throw hands, we can throw hands. But you're gonna keep them guns out.
We're gonna do a lot more than throw hands, motherfucker. I'ma see you in that ring. There ain't gonna be no straight rap shit though, you feel me?
That's cool.
Me and you got a problem as men. We battle as men, not just as rappers.
That's cool. We could do that.
Understood. Right?
Yep. I'm sorry. A rap battle? You want to solve this with a rap battle?
Shut the fuck up.
No, I'm over here pissing my pants. That actually might be literal. Thinking I'm surrounded by straight up gangsters packing heat about to blow my brains all over this lovely interior decor, but no. You think the most street way to deal with this is with a rap battle? That thing where a bunch of grown ass men get together in a room, call each other gang, come up with make believe ways we're totally gonna kill each other? I mean, is that not the corniest shit you've ever heard in your life? Is that thing even real? Great to meet you all. Come on up to Berkeley sometime. We settle beef with word debates there too. Can you believe how ridiculous that was? Think this silly insult game we play so seriously? I mean, I love it, but come on. I thought we're in a life or death situation back there.
Stop the car.
Oh, yeah? Wanna grab a drink? Ooh, we should do a toast to Chase's big battle.
Stop the fucking car. I'm having a fucking panic attack.
Oh. Sorry, man. I have anxiety myself. I know how it is. And that was an insane situation. I just figured you had a handle on it.
Why? Because I'm black? So I'm supposed to be in the streets like that? I'm a fucking video game designer, dog.
You're what? Oh, this is you fucking with me.
No. It's my daughter's life.
You have a daughter? So the slang, the accent, it's an act.
This ain't no act. You never heard of code switching, motherfucker?
Right. Of course. Sorry, I didn't mean to make any assumptions. I just thought that you...
Look, I know what you thought. You think I need a white boy to tell me what he thought of me?
Battle rap is not boxing. It's a street fight. You won't just get your jaw broke. You got someone right in your face trying to tear you apart. Your job, your girl, dick pics you sent in high school. It's fair game. That's why I keep my private business actually private, and I never use personals on my opponent neither. I just talk about shooting them.
Okay.
What is that? Look, front, back, front, salute. Got it?
Got it.
All right, that was great. Got a long way to Oakland to work on that.
Shit.
Time is a...
Hey, do you think since we're going back to your place anyway that I could stay at...
I got you.
This is awesome, man. I'm honestly surprised.
You would be surprised. You're a racist piece of shit.
Yeah, I know. I'm trying hard not to be.
I believe you really think that. Look, before we get up there, my wife got a problem with people calling me my rap name. So call me Osiris or Oz.
Your real name is Osiris?
Yeah.
But your rap name is Behn.
Yeah.
Okay.
Man, I can hear the racist shit you thinking. Yeah, everything is good, you know? Man, my wife make the best burnt bacon ever.
Yeah?
Yeah, man. Gotta have the best.
Boy, take that hat off.
Can I be done now?
Give me one more bite, baby. Nope, 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 nope. Give me one bigger than that. There you go. Now you done, okay?
Oz.
I got it. I got it. I got it. Hey, baby, it's okay. It's okay. It's okay. There you go. There you go. Just how we practice, okay? Big, deep breaths. Yeah.
Think of it like you're breathing down into your tummy. In and out. In and out. There you go.
Feeling better?
Mm-hmm.
You wanna go watch a little TV?
Okay.
Come on, okay? Daddy, take you, come on. Come on, baby, we'll watch it.
I was staring at Ellie.
I like that one too, I'll watch it with you.
Cystic fibrosis. She's had it since she was born. Her lungs get clogged up and it just makes it hard for her to breathe.
That's really tough. I'm sorry.
So, Adam, what do you do? I mean, besides appropriate black culture for your livelihood.
That's hilarious. Oh, okay. I'm a student, English lit major. I'm actually more interested in what Behn Oz does, to be honest with you. Video game design, how did you get into that?
I stabbed a video game designer and took his laptop.
Really?
What's wrong with you? I went to college.
And do they, no?
About the battle raps? Yeah.
And they're cool with it?
But with a black guy being a rapper? Well, you know what? I'm gonna be honest, it does get annoying sometimes when you work on an FPS and then you got all these dudes come up to you asking details about a gun.
Well, it's great that your wife is so supportive of you battling.
Why wouldn't I?
It's just my girlfriend isn't, because of all the women bashing and stuff. I just thought you may be against it because it portrays a certain negative image.
I see we got no respectability politics-ass motherfucker at the table. No, I got it. You really want to sit here and spout off about negative image when we both know that no matter how much money he makes, no matter how well he speaks, no matter how many suits he puts on, he can still go out and get shot in the street by the police for no reason. That I could have the same fate, that my daughter can. So if he's gonna make money by battling and put food on this here table with the talents that God has given him, oh, you damn right I'ma support him. No matter how many of y'all little white boys come up in here talking about how negative it might be.
You live in Rock Ridge, it's the safest neighborhood in Oak.
Damn it! I can't believe I just had to black-splain some shit to you in my own damn house.
Maybe that's all white people need, is just to have someone explain stuff to us.
So it's not enough that this country was literally built off of our oppression, but now that we get an iota of freedom, we gotta go explaining that same oppression back to y'all. No, not tonight, Satan. I need to go make me some tea. And Oz, I love you. But if you think that MC Microaggression here is spending one night under this here roof, both of y'all can go find yourselves a hotel room where you can discuss black-on-black crime together.
She bodied you, nigga.
I felt bad when it was a black guy, but look at all his privilege. White kids choosing to be homeless so they can act like Kerouac are the reason we don't have communism.
Actually, the reason we don't have communism is you're undermining of the interracial solidarity and class consciousness of the proletariat.
And you look like you smoke pumpkin spice out of a junkie's pipe.
Adam?
Hey, babe. I was hoping we could talk. now that we've had a chance to cool off.
It's funny. This is exactly what your father said you would do.
You talked to my dad about our relationship.
Well, he had some prescient insights, actually. He pointed out the parallels with Dimitri and Katya and the brothers Karamazov.
This conversation's really, really important to me. Can you hold on a second? I have to take this call. Yo.
Yo, Adam, what's goody?
Honey Grams. This is awesome. It's an honor.
All right, word. All right, check it out, right? We got an event end of the month where we setting up Megaton versus Shay to deal with all this beef out here, okay? And I thought it'd be extra dope to have a co-headliner. Adam versus Behn Grymm.
Can you hold on a sec? I have a huge opportunity. Huge for us.
Is it your window of opportunity for begging for my forgiveness?
You don't understand.
I don't understand. I don't even know who the hell you are right now. Do you?
One sec. Grams.
Yeah, you playing hardball, huh? Tell you what. You take the match, I got 5 racks for y'all. Each.
It's not about the money.
This could be the biggest match of your career. People always want to see the master face his protege, okay? If you go off, you a legend for life.
Okay, I'll take the battle.
What battle?
Maya. The lifelong battle of winning back your trust?
I'm hanging up now.
No, don't. I'll get rid of the other call. Okay, it's just you and me now. I promise.
Whoa, I'm just offering a matchup.
Wait, who's this?
100 fucking grams. Town business. Look, there ain't no you and me all of a sudden, okay? I mean, you got some shit, but I ain't trying to make a funny white boy my flagship artist or nothing. No offense.
Yo, I mean, hey, I mean, who?
So, the other call is gone?
Right. Okay, babe. It's done.
The fuck you call me?
You, the fuck, called me.
What you doing with your voice now? Offer a white boy some money and y'all get weird as shit.
I think I accidentally merged the two calls.
Adam, who is this?
Oh, so you really is a bitch. Yo, your voice sounds sexy. I like a woman who sounds like she's about to make my ass pay alimony.
Oh my god.
Pig? And I am not saying that because you're black, and I'm not even assuming that you are, but damn it, Adam! Ugh, why do you always make me sound so racist?
That's the keeper, bruh. For real. So, what's going with the battle?
I'm not doing any more battles. Ever again. I'm out. I just lost my girlfriend for good. I got beat up by a vegan. And I'm sleeping on a fucking park bench all because of battle rap. You guys don't even take me seriously. Plus, everywhere I go, people think I'm some neo-Nazi racist. It's just like I'm walking around yelling, shink, kike, gook, spick, faggot, right?
I've been getting reports of a homeless man on this bench verbally accosting passersby. What can you tell me about this?
I haven't seen anyone. I should get to class.
Yeah, that fool! Kidnap that fool!
It's the perfect timing. You see the man shining. Go and get them goddamn diamonds.
Mike, can I talk to you for a second?
You left her stranded in a Los Angeles ghetto. She has nothing to say.
She left me stranded. That's not important right now. Look, Maya, I just want you to know that I'm quitting rap battling. For real, it turned me into a complete asshole. I totally get it.
All right, everyone. As you know, we have subject thesis presentations today. A brave soul among you has volunteered to go first. Maya.
Oh, please, don't give me the sad puppy dog act. I know you think you're the hero of this story and that I'm just the cliche, controlling bitch girlfriend who the audience is supposed to hate. But have you ever stopped to think I might be a bitch with a point? That the real problem here isn't the tone of what I'm saying, but it's the content of what you've said? Ugh. Your life fails the Bechdel test.
Yes. Get it.
You okay?
Yeah. Thanks, Mr. Kendall. So, the subject of my thesis is the cultural legitimization of white racism in America as free expression. I plan to trace this idea from its emergence in the mid-20th century when racism became less forthright and more coded through today.
Look, I understand where you're coming from. I want to quit this shit half the time, too. You think I really want to battle a homie? It's 5 G's on the line, and I know my family could really use that money. I got a few unexpected bills for Grace. I'm not gonna bore you with that. I'm just asking you as a friend, Would you please take the
bell? Why are you even talking to that I don't see color type racist ass bum? I told you, young white privilege ain't trying to help nobody but his damn self. Oh, dumb motherfucker.
Is Battle Rap. Now, what started as an authentic African-American experience has been co-opted, like so many other things, by white supremacists as a space to say obscenely racist things under the guise of competition. Trigger warning. In addition to its vile racism, this video contains transphobia, slut-shaming, and an enormous douchebag.
Even Asian bitches will fuck you. That means you're hella frail. Ordering tuna at sushi's the only time you get yellow tail.
You just take a real customer squeeze.
Cause you really don't know what you're fucking with, like you had a one-night stand in Thailand. Faggot!
The F slur, Adam, really. That's not only offensive, that's offensively basic.
You can bet your guaylo ass that every Asian on campus is gonna know about this.
Well, I thought it was hilarious. I don't even mind that you use that word. You've always been a faggot to me.
Thank you.
Do you know who the fuck I am?
Nah, nah.
Do you know who the fuck I am? Your fam, I am the motherfucking man.
No, we should.
Oh, I can come back if you're busy.
No, come on in. Have a seat. What are you doing here?
I'm kind of homeless. I was wondering if I could stay with you for a few days.
No. Why do you smell like cocoa butter?
Well, I spent the last week sleeping on a bench. The last homeless guy left a bottle there. My skin was all dry. You know what I mean? I don't mean you. I just mean because you're a nurse.
I'm the dean of this school.
So after Maya showed that video of your battle in class yesterday, that went viral. The administration is now under a lot of pressure to act. Now you know how sensitive the climate is towards racism and appropriation. And your performance was downright Iggy Azalean.
Why does the school care about what I do in my private
life? It's 2018. There is no private life. The university cannot afford a scandal right now. The Asian American Association is ready to turn this into bien den fou, and the Jewish Law Students Association is already filing a harassment lawsuit against the campus.
I didn't say anything about Jewish people.
Well, that may well be, but many members of the JSLA are dating members of the Asian American Association, so what do you have against interracial relationships?
Huh? And there's the added visibility factor of me being your father. And like it or not, people notice when Kylo Ren has a force tantrum because he's Han Solo's son. Sorry, Dean, spoilers.
I know this looks bad, but it's all for my thesis subject, which is on the use of the word nigga.
Excuse me?
Sorry. Behn Grymm told me that it's more respectful to say nigga.
The rock monster from the Fantastic Four said you could use the N-word.
It's black. I gotta go to class.
Actually, you don't. Effective immediately, your scholarship
what?
Is being 30 years in academia, and every man still thinks his balls have the right to interrupt me. I said that effective immediately, your scholarship is being suspended.
Don't look at me. I gotta think about my own situation here. If I'm seen publicly supporting your comments, I'll be like the next insert whatever idiot the internet's mad at today.
Sir, disown me.
Adam, use a less plutocratic word than disowning.
I'm not a racist. How can you judge someone based off one clip on YouTube?
Because I wrote the book. Several.
People pay for what they do, and still more for what they allow themselves to become. James Baldwin. And to quote a more contemporary African-American writer, that was the realest shit he ever wrote.
Well, if Karamazov did commit patricide, then I wouldn't be that surprised.
That's precisely the rhetoric I can't abide.
Well, I am being bastardized.
Are you trying to satirize?
If I did, then would you be satisfied?
Stop rhyming, you little shit!
This family is fucked up.
Come on! Come on, what's my name? DMX, and I be the best. You see the rest, they looking like they need a rest.
Asian Americans against Adam!
We win!
understandable urge to tear his limbs from his body.
Just off the enemy.
Delete your account.
You got everybody out here getting our culture fucked up. Again, thanks for that. Get woke, cocksucker.
Ben? I'm in. Let's do it.
Institutionalized man sanity, but don't sleep on the two dope ass spinners that we got right here, right now. Now, I know you hear all the jokes about Asian men never getting together with black women, but fuck that, we did it, y'all. Can y'all break it down all type of barriers, you dig?
You ready for this?
I hope so.
This is a special one round matchup. Both rappers requested this, so you know it's gonna be some cold ass shit. Rap on my right, state your name.
Divine White, cause I'm the motherfucking queen of this shit.
Nervous rap on the left, state your name, soldier.
Prospect, representing K-Town, Los Angeles, stay the fuck up.
Looking like you drank from the wrong grill or some shit. You good?
Good.
Respect for taking the match. Check should definitely help. Tracy doing good. It should be good for you, man. I hope you kill
him. I can't wait to see what you got.
Right. I got some shit. Either way, we're gonna be boys.
After all, nothing personal, right?
Right. Let you do your thing.
Now, Divine chose to go first. So it's all on you, Queen. Let's get it.
Fuck this Asian motherfucker. Fuck this kamikaze plane. Tamagotchi playing, shots of sake taking motherfucker.
What the fuck?
Fuck Lucy Liu and Sulu too. Fuck your ninja stars, your Subaru. Fuck Buddha and Confucius too. Wait, actually, I don't know if I should be rhyming all that. I don't know how China attacks. I'm not trying to get a cyber attack and trying to get hacked.
It's disrespectful.
If you were in your deathbed and saw your life in a flash, it'd be you designing an app, dining on cats, and doing science and math.
What the fuck is he doing? This fool is killing himself right now. Samurais take this Harry Carey shit seriously, bruh.
Your family's either making civics or has a nail and facial business. I'm surprised the movie Crash didn't have more Asians in it. Why is it so hard for you to drive? I seen Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon. You motherfuckers used to fly. You know what you call going with an Asian on an Uber ride?
What's that?
Suicide. If I cut your voice box, I bet you bleed soy sauce. When you're at the arcade, they mistaken your eyes for the coin slots. This Asian is an overachiever. You'll be catching more dogs than you could store in the freezer. Your idea of playing catch is throwing a cleaver at a golden retriever. So if I call you a rice farming, bootlegging, dry cleaning, bad driving piece of shit, and these dudes will laugh. And if you're wondering why I'm dissing Asians, you do the math.
I don't know what the fuck just happened, but I love what the fuck just happened.
Fine. I know you're not gonna let him talk to him. I mean, talk to you like that, right?
Hell no.
All right, let's get it then.
This bitch got at me for being Asian. But came with some weak shit. So now I gotta get on my shit, dissing ladies, cause that's clearly what she is. Ain't no vagina blast that can give her a tighter snatch. This bitch got a wider gap than the income between white and black.
That's a wide gap. That's a wide gap.
If she ain't giving up the pussy, you could get sucked in. That's a black hoe. I said, even if she ain't giving up the pussy, you could get sucked in. That's a black hoe. Before I even let the gun kiss her, I'ma get this bitch a tic-tac. Ooh, cause her breath is so foul, when she spit it, gotta kick back. They be having stage fright when I whip out this dick, cause it'll make a bitch choke and then forget how to spit. She's too ugly to even feed her the D. The only way a nigga keep her in G's, if she Aisha Curry in her cooking, make niggas weak in the knees. She be having welfare babies, but I get a hustle respect. Cause we both sunning niggas just for the check. I know y'all confused about what we doing, so check it, we just figured. We flip the same shit we always hear from you fuck niggas so proud. We killed this shit. We fucking them up, nigga. And as for the rest of y'all, y'all can do them cliche bars. But you can't do them better than us, nigga.
Devon won that clearly, no debate.
Yeah, but she was going at herself, basically, so... Prospect?
Nah, Prospect lost, but he was dissing Asian, so which means he beat himself?
You need algebra for this shit, bro.
That's some shit that can only happen in Oakland, you feel me? Make some noise for those fools, Body, and everybody within a 5-mile radius with that shit.
It worked out perfect.
Hell yeah, your female bars is crazy.
Yo, your Asian bars too, they gonna make China no fly zone for you.
That shit was wild, bro. Y'all took me on a roller coaster of emotions.
I don't know how many people here got what y'all did. Pure genius.
Your sensei would be proud, bro. Oh, he died.
Wait, for real?
Yeah, he got in another fight at the restaurant and one dude pulled a knife out. Roundhouse like four dudes before he dropped. That went out like a G. Dope battle anyway.
We gonna need a minute to recover from that. But coming up next though, we got my man Behn Grymm versus Adam, okay? Where the hell is Adam at? Adam, come to the ring. Where is Adam? Why is the white boy on CP time?
He thought as some old white boy that he would scare me pale. You can't rep the Brothers Grimm. Your life is a fairy tale.
Hit with a combo breaker, the Boston Strangler for the cost of the Vegas. You soccer player slash commentator, La Bamba singer. Shouts out to all the Spanish Armada Raiders that came through your fucking crib and took your mom and raped her.
Behn Grymm.
Rap on my left, he didn't need an intro.
So just fucking do this.
Alright. Adam won the coin toss, so it's 2 minutes on Behn. Let's work.
Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Okay.
They talking wild out here.
What they say?
Like I ain't better than my own protege. Well, you and Megaton both taking nails tonight, cause he ain't even a protege. And as for Adam, the Macklemore didn't hurt him, you get lowered into an open grave. You thrift shopping. You get put in a suit off some throwaways. Redheaded bitches is freaks. Cause me and his mom, known to get wild. It's more than a metaphor when I treat this redhead like my stepchild.
Look at his face. Look at his face.
We didn't even make it to the room. I smashed her in the lobby. I'm like a priest at the communion. I turned this cracker into a bot. He performed spoken word. So after I slam this poet, he'll feel back in his prime. Cause I ain't gotta clap him. I just snap him after his lines. So it was never really right to call this cat a rookie. You know, spoken word is like dental dam. It's just a rap for puss. His mom and dad is rich. So if we rob him, it's more than snatching a chain. I hit him with the silver spoon so far back in his mouth, he gets stabbed in the brain. I revoke your hood pass. Make sure you're not good in here. His last name is Merkin, so you know he got a fake pussy, eh? You a culture thief, a vulture, a leech. Why are you using the voice that black people use to talk to police? You grew up Broadway and Park Place. You not in these streets. I put the iron to this square like a Monopoly piece. He's so mad he can't be black, he's bitter. When teachers asked him what he wanted to be when he grew up, he answered, a nigga. So out of spite, he became a Klansman. But black men is what this faggot is into. How you KKK when you fuck black men? You the Kardashian sister. All your shit for pro was racist. But you say you not racist.
That's some crazy stuff. This nigga starts every sentence he ever say with, I hate to be racist, but. You a high and soft type cracker. When I'm done with this soft white rapper, he'll be on lines after, typing, all lives matter.
Said my mom's a whore?
Yeah.
He did say that. Yeah. He did say that.
Well, you're right. So it's time you got some viral shots. Because if it burns when you piss now, you know why they call her a fire crotch?
That boy don't play.
What? What? You thought since I'm a white boy that he would scare me pale? You can't rep the brothers, Grimm. Your life is a fairy tale.
Wow, Brother Grimm.
You and your wife were on some Boy Meets World shit, and she's at best average. You've been with one bitch your whole life. Don't try to tell me Ben Savage. He doesn't have a set he's banging. He was busy wedding planning. How you gonna make that bitch Topanga when her pussy looks like Topanga Canyon? Guns you say you pack, man. The enormous are knocking boots. And when I'm done, I might kill that prostitute like I'm trying to keep my Grand Theft Auto loot. Yeah, she swallows too. She's like Kirby, how she's inhaling every drop. Then I'll do her like Metal Gear and put my Solid Snake in her box. Uh-huh. You don't own a Soul Calibur. If you control a gun, it's Nintendo brand. That's why the block won't fill your lines like you were in a Tetris jam. Where are you pulling weapons from? Cause you got punked by Megaton without a tech in hand. If you really had those big arms, you would have taken a shot at Mega, man. Now you're probably wondering why I designed these bars about video games for my writtens. It's cause this motherfucker designs video games for a living. Tell him the truth. Tell him these gum bars are just bluffing for fame. Tell him what you really mean when you say you're making money from the game. You ain't going hard to the gutter. You're dealing with marketing numbers. If you got firepower from the pipe, you're playing Mario Brothers. The closest thing you get to beef is when kids on Xbox trash talk to each other. The closest you get to pimping is when you come home and tell your daughter you love her. Oh, shit. Y'all didn't know? Yeah, he's a family man. So if he's talking about sharing cells, it ain't jail. He's just got a family plan. So I'm exposing my own friend. I'm on that white devil shit. I just showed this game designer what the next level is.
What he saying true? I'm riding with the real gangster.
You finna be over here catching them straight shrapnel for no fraud, man?
Hold up, y'all switching sides? Y'all switching sides? Oh, man, that's cold, bro. Hey, Grimm, you want to pass the controller? Or you got something for Adam, Mr. Video Game Man?
So you want to diss my wife? Cool. Guess I gotta let you know what's up. For coming out of Raw, I have bullets riddling your frame, nigga. Now focus up. I'm a beast to this boy. I shoot at his team and clap whoever. MCA, Ad Rock, Adam either die first or lose his mans forever. And they say he'll kill me. It's over him, the priests say amen. The tables is turned, they mourning Adam like he DJ AM. Your girl dumped you over some battle rap shit. It's a true story, B. So, you lost some pussy to win a battle? Only thing fucked is your priorities. Her name is Maya, like the people who worship gods and savage rites. So it's only right that Maya ripped his heart out like a human sacrifice. His dad's a famous writer. So wherever you go, his shadow hits you. What a surprise. Another white bitch with daddy issues. They say you're a dope writer, but you're not the best in your family, is you? Shit. If he was to battle with you, you'd be Marvin Gaye. Your old man will kill you. You're a Shermanator, impersonator, walking around here with your panties tangled. Corniest redheaded bitch in rap since Jay flipped the Annie salad. See, we both got treated like disease because society didn't like us. Well, fuck that. I'd rather have nigga-itis than gingivitis. See, it was that one time I let you try saying nigga fast, but it really don't matter if you get a nigga pass if you ain't felt the nigga's pass. If we was to go around and start killing crackers, I'm coming to your college where you chill, son. You thought we wouldn't get revenge from Mike Brown? I catch you there and will, son.
Black Lives Matter.
He did a school project on battle rap. That's the only reason ho ass got to talk to me. So here's my interview answer, Adam. Eat a dick, and you better quote that properly.
Wow, now we got a battle. Now we got a battle. Behn Grymm got his balls back.
Aye, man. Spack on my white boy. Let's finish this motherfucker, man.
You wanna get personal? Let's get personal. His real name is Osiris. That's the Egyptian death god, whose wife is Isis, which is perfect, because if he's home late, she'll take his fucking head off. Yeah, my bitch ripped my heart out. At least that's the only body part I've gone. Your bitch, call LeBron with how easy she keeps your balls in her palm. She's a stuck-up cunt. Wherever they go, she makes them pay. The way you stunt to stay in the box, it's like you're David Blaine. I just wonder what your ancestors who were slaves would say. Cause you get cuffed and whipped by the ball and chain till you're 50 shades of gray.
He's going in on my feet.
Hey man, holler me later. I'm a good divorce lawyer, baby.
But for real, I respect how having a family changed your life's focus. Especially after your kid was diagnosed with cystic fibrosis. That's why you did this battle, to pay for her care with the funds. So you're putting food in her plate. Too bad you can't put air in her lungs! With every breath she takes, she feels the sting like it's hard labor. She sounds like Darth Vader choking to death in a jawbreaker. The shit she coughs up looks like an abstract painting. She'll probably be an art major. She can't do the most basic parts of living. It's obvious God hates her. And now your battling career's finished. It's running its course. It's like your daughter gasping for breath and always coming up short. You hate the things other men would love to hear from their daughters. Like when she tells you you're the air that she breathes, it means you're a terrible father. So I'll blow my secondhand smoke all in her face, and it's not a mistake. Then I'll flick my cigarette in her fucking oxygen tank. And the gene for her disease is mostly found in white men. So you should have some questions for your wife then. Like, why the fuck is she so light-skinned?
Yo, let me see. You're not the father, man. Let me see it.
Yo, shut the fuck up when I'm rapping. You're trying to be my hype man? I'd rather make you cannon fodder. I could beat you on a two-on-two match if I had his daughter as my partner.
Yo, chill out, bro, because we're bigging you up.
No, you shut the fuck up. You're talking during my rounds and about his daughter.
No, you're talking about his daughter. What are you talking about?
Yeah, we was in a battle. Y'all just
talking. You're talking during my rounds.
Keep it rap.
Yo, we can be in a fucking battle if you want, since y'all on the same side all of a sudden.
Wait, you're calling us out to battle right now?
If you feel a type of way.
Yeah, we feel some type of way. You talking about my motherfucking daughter, love?
Let's
doing thing, nigga. What the fuck is you talking about?
This is some old school battle type shit, okay? We about to have a freestyle battle off the top. No rules, no time limits. Make some noise for that, okay? Now, 40 and blunt. Since y'all called him out, y'all down to go first?
Well, always, man.
Let's get it in there.
Adam, right? You've been soft half your life. I should grab your mics and Jack's son. It don't matter if you're black or white.
No, white now, I'm black and like, I'm a star with this fake G-Eazy. I'm greasy as mama's fried.
Dollar fried.
Been picking out in these battles, huh?
But they ain't get the scoop we call it.
Anybody hogging dies. What y'all?
The new M and Dre? Fake renegade, and you been afraid. Center stage, and I slay. It's beyond saying you lemonade. You gon' get this work, nigga. You definitely gon' get this work.
You started rapping a couple days ago, and you made games for PlayStation 4. But it's gun PlayStation 1. You gotta wait the load.
Y'all team seem iffy.
That's cause they theme scream Disney. His jeans scream hippie and his cheeks scream pinch me. They a couple.
They a couple?
That's what I heard.
Oh, so in this battle, y'all really fought? Oh, tonight is gonna be some real awkward pillow talk.
Nah. They an odd couple. That's why they not even. Oh. And if you talk about my daughter in this battle, you'll be the one that's not breathing, motherfucker.
You talk shit to bitch and whine because I replied? I guess this is the future Drake wanted. What a time to be alive.
These rounds will leave you bleed. Then let's see how they can talk. It's not one for the dead homies when they see that 40 pouring on the block.
You don't need canes to move. You need canes to move. Your old has-beens can't even watch their own matches without turning on closed captions.
Both forms in their face look like they both dabbing.
And even though I'm white, I'll light blunts.
Cause we don't feel they got the flavor for dope rapping. See, they pull up, I spot. Then I stretch them like a personal trainer. Then I lift their soul up.
Like it's a personal savior.
I'm not trying to say all that.
It's my personal favor.
I'm trying to let these shells out early. They got perfect behavior.
Where you're not wanted. That's how I know what it feels like to be gentrified.
How you gonna raise your fist to me like you ain't got a sense of pride? I'm not hating. I'm just saying you're on that transgender vibe. The way you switching sides, I can see the bitch inside.
You're a bitch, Bag. All you do is talk gossip shit and weight loss.
Cause that's the only way these niggas will get some flames off.
Is if we did a face swap.
Why you wearing jewelry? You don't supply drugs.
And why are you wearing that when you're the one that looks like they got shot by a plug? I'm Eminem, cause I'm white and can rhyme.
No, wait. Now, if we're talking history, then that's Puck and that's Biggie. The only tragedy is that they didn't die in their prime.
Time!
Adam, that was crazy, man. I mean, I always knew you was nice with it, but I never knew you went hard like that. Wow.
Respect.
Yo, that daughter shit, man. When you said you blow up her oxygen tank, that shit was crazy as fuck. That's why I watch rap battles. Bodies entire family.
Respects. That battle was awesome. That 2-on-2, people gonna be talking about that forever. Shoot some more of those.
You have the papers right.
If shit got that heated between friends, imagine what's gonna happen when we actually put two people in the ring who don't really fuck with each other. That's exactly what's about to happen, because the main event of the epoch is going down right now.
I'm glad we're cool after all the shit that I said. But it's battle rap. I need to understand.
Yeah, I understand.
We ain't cool, though.
The gunner interrupt you on stage, I'll grab the mag and Yeezy him. Come on, y'all get it?
We got more.
Iron, minerals, magnesium. Interrupt them on stage, grab the mag and fucking Yeezy him. I need to wake the fuck up.
You the only one tired.
What about the 212? We killed it up there.
Look, we cool on some rap shit. I respect your artistry. You can put together some bars. We ain't friends.
But it's battle rap. You said a bunch of personal stuff about me. Anything goes into battle, right?
Yeah, anything goes. But you think your words ain't got fucking consequences? Everybody calling you out on your shit. My girl, your girl, the whole Berkeley student body. And you keep telling yourself that they just don't understand. So you can feel like a good person. But you know, you need to realize, you're not. You are not a good person. You're a degenerate scumbag. That's where you belong.
Where are you going?
Where I belong. Home with my family.
You're a motherfucking legend, bro. Legends respect legends. Keep doing your thing. You heard?
All right. Now you fucking with that? I know y'all want. Check this out, Camel Breeder. Your hoe ain't loyal. She don't care a bit, motherfucker. That's why I fucked your bitch, you Arab bitch, motherfucker. You walked in on us fucking. She still try to tell you, baby, I'm just flirting. She a porn star. She took out the camera and said, baby, I'm just working.
Time. Mega, it's on you, bro.
Get my soul, mijo. I'm about to murder you in front of your old people. Grab the Chrome Eagle and do a drive-by in front of Home Depot. I don't give a fuck if you're from El Salvador or Puerto Rico. That don't matter to me, bro. Because if you can pack 44 of your folks and your close amigos in a little four-door Pinto, then you're Latino. You think I give a fuck if you and my bitch date? And I heard y'all kiss? Well, that was your mistake, because now you can tell everybody in the crowd how my dick tastes. What? So what, you fuck my bitch over to everyone else? And she said you had a small dick. Matter of fact, I'ma have her tell you herself.
Yo, yes, I fucked this pussy, and yes, I'm a porn star if you can't tell. I'd say he satisfied me. But I can't even fake it that well. To have a below average dick, you need to be a couple inches bigger. Yo, you thought we was fucking? I thought I was being fingered.
This better be good, Adam.
Hey, Bae. Maya. Thanks for picking up. I know it's late. And I'm also probably the last person you expected to or wanted to talk to right now. But there's just something I really need to say to you, so please, just listen.
This is fucking late, dude. You just gonna let him walk in a fucking special fucking guest? This ain't just a wave now, huh? Fucking battles of guest fucking verses, man? Some bullshit, man. Fuck that. I'm out this bitch.
You lost anyway.
I completely understand why you did what you did with the PowerPoint. And I forgive you. I deserve it. Even, God, I was so terrible to you, to our friends, to the whole world. What I realized is that you were right. You said this wasn't me. I'm not this person. I'm not like those guys. The best version of myself, the real version of myself is when I was with you. You make me a better person. You make me me. I want to be with you for the rest of my life. With no more time off, or mistakes, or wrong directions. Maya, what I'm trying to say is, will you marry me?
get married?
Yes. Yes, more than anything else in the world. Yes.
Are you out of your fucking mind? Delete my number, you fucking racist, homophobic, misogynistic fuck, and stay the fuck away from me.
My opponent quit like a coward, so I guess I gotta start killing the squad. Starting with this bitch over here looking like Biggie Minaj. Oh, you look like Rod Digger.
Bitch, I will
if she was
way.
Crossed with Godzilla. White dude, an Asian, a black girl, and a Mexican. Who the fuck y'all supposed to be? The United Colors of Benetton? Bitch, it's like the rap version of the Village.
Yo, chill.
Get the fuck out of my face, bro. Wake the fuck up. Any one of you motherfuckers, little punk ass chumps, I'll battle any one of y'all at once. Tell Ben what's up. What's up, Mag? What's up, Buns? I'll fuck both of you up.
See,
yeah. And y'all ain't nothing but chumps. Every single one of you fucks. I thought Adam, you was a freestyler, right? Then show me what's up. Come on, bitch. Show me what's up, you little fucking worm. Let's get it, you dinky ass green, you little fucking dinky sucking. Come show me some of them freestyles, you fuck boy. Man, I ain't the fucking kid to step to. You see this? It's that look you have on your face when you've been crying all day because your bitch just left you. Maybe it's because she found your boy George tapes and realized that you go both ways. Or maybe it's no one wants to procreate with their Macaulay Culkin traits and have a kid born one day with the same pointy nose and oval-shaped Topher Grace / Norman Bates looking bony face. They got me all the way out here in the Golden State battling with the same little white bitch that Tupac and Kobe raped. Before this cracker learned about the Black Panthers through his dad's lectures, oh, he wanted to be a Klan member, but he found out he can't enter because they don't accept people that are transgender. Yeah. For setting this up, fuck you too. I don't trust you either. You should know the only reason that he wants to be here is because he got jungle fever, looking like Justin Bieber in a fucking muscle t-shirt. You're a fucking fan of Hanson, Marilyn Manson's grandson. This is a body bag that you ain't coming back from. Straight up!
Yo, shut the fuck up! You think you're a super villain? I'm about to tear your mask off, because now you're talking to the devil like Ivan Karamazov. You think because you were a terrorist, martyr, Arabic scholar preparing for Allah that you can't be served? You're not a suicide bomber just because you got the eyebrows of an angry bird. So I'll go grab Shay and then I'll bust you till the chopper jams on your falafel stand from his taco van. You're dating a porn star. We all know what her vagina's touched. Most terrorists get 72 virgins. You got a bitch who's fucked 72 guys at once. Do you think this shit's real? You call me a faggot and half of these guys collapse from laughter. Well, battle rap is so fucking corny. I'm a battle rapper. Here's an example. You caught Shay with your girl and didn't throw a fist at the dude, but you punched someone for getting in your face. But if someone's getting in your bitch, then it's cool. These battlers, they're all soft. They just pull the tough guy shit for the views. Well, I'm all up in your face now, so what the fuck is this bitch gonna do?
Whoa, what you gonna do?
What the fuck, man? That little love tap? That was real touching. But I just murdered my old friend, so you should know that I don't feel nothing. You tap chins when you know you can't win. You thought she could leave me on the ground? I might have lost a tooth, but fuck it. I just beat you for the crown.
Worry about it, man. You good.
always say. I always say.
Playing ping pong.
This is the one you've been hearing about. If I came back from the future to tell myself this shit happened, I'd tell myself to get the fuck out of here. A battle is so new, he doesn't even have a fucking rap name. Going up against the ultimate juggernaut of the scene. On the spot.
Enough. I know what my rap name should be. My name is...
My name is...
What?
My name is...
What?
My name is...
His name's Sadie.
My name is...
Huh?
My name is...
What?
My name is... My name is
what?
Excuse
me.
My name is
what?
Can I have the attention of the class? My name for one second. My name is
Hi kids, do you like violence?
Yeah,
wanna
yeah,
see
yeah.
me stick 9-inch nails to each one of my eyelids?
Uh-huh.
Wanna copy me and do exactly like I did?
Yeah,
try
yeah.
sit and get fucked up worse than my life is? My brain's dead weight. I'm trying to get my head straight, but I can't figure out which Spice Girl I want to impregnate. And Dr. Dre said,
Slim Shady, you a basic. So why's your face red? Man, you wasted.
Well, since age 12, I felt like I'm someone else, because I hung my original self from the top bunk with a belt. Got pissed off and ripped Pamela Lee's tits off and smacked it so hard I knocked her clothes backwards like Chris Paul. I smoke a fat pound of grass and fall on my ass faster than a fat bitch who sat down too fast. Come here, slut.
Shady, wait a minute. That's my girl, dawg.
I don't give a fuck. God sent me to piss the world off.
Hi, my name is...
What?
My name is...
What?
My name is...
Teacher wanted to flunk me in junior high. Thanks a lot. Next semester, I'll be 35. I smacked him in his face with an eraser. Chased him with a stapler. Stapled his nuts to a stack of paper. Walked in a strip club. Had my jacket zipped up. Blast a bartender. And stuck my dick in a tip cup. Extraterrestrial. Running over pedestrians in a spaceship while they screaming at me.
Let's just be friends.
99% of my life, I was lied to. I just found out my mom does more dope than I do. I told her I'd grow up to be a famous rapper. Make a record about doing drugs and name it after. You know you blew up when the women rush your stands and try to touch your hands like some screaming Usher fans. This guy at White Castle asked for my autograph, so I signed it. Dear Dave, thanks for the support, asshole.
My name is... My name is... My name is...
This kid needs to be locked away.
Get him!
Dr. Dre, don't just stand there, operate. I'm not ready to leave. It's too scary to die. I'll have to be carried inside the cemetery and buried alive.
Yep.
Am I coming or going? I can barely decide. I just drank a fifth of vodka. Dare me to drive?
Go ahead.
All my life I was very deprived. I ain't had a woman in years, and my palms are too hairy to hide.
Whoops.
Clothes ripped like the Incredible Hulk. I spit when I talk. I fuck anything that walks.
Come here.
When I was little, I used to get so hungry, I would throw fits.